And I'm so glad to introduce her to you here on the Southern Scene, Kandice Pelletier. Hi, Kandice.
Oh, Natalie, it's so good to be here.
It's so great to see you. I'm so glad to have you here on the Southern Scene, back in Savannah.
Back in Savannah, where it all started.
I know.
When I was a tadpole.
I know, and here you are. Here you are. And you talk about how beautiful Savannah is.
Oh, I miss it so much. The trees, the people, the culture, the food. The food we had today was amazing. I just really miss this.
And now you're in New York. I mean, you know, well, let's go through and kind of walk our viewers through a timeline here.
Okay.
I mean, because, you know, when you and I met many years ago, I mean, you were in pageantry. You did the whole thing. You came up through performing arts, a fabulous dancer, and you went through pageantry.
So I was first runner-up to Miss Georgia. That was a year. I ended up moving to New York. I wanted to be a Rockette. It was a dream of mine. So I moved to New York, eventually became Miss New York. That year was a great year. I was made into a wax figure at Madame Tussauds, which was like my claim to fame.
You know, I was so amazed to watch Kandice grow. I mean, because, you know, I knew her as this young pageant girl. And then to actually come to New York and have the opportunity to see you on stage as a Rockette, I mean, that was fabulous.
Thank you, Nat. Thank you. That was a special night, too.
I remember
you guys pulling up in a limo, and I was like, look at this. These are my fans. It was so fun.
What was it like being a Rockette, Kandice?
You know, it was the hardest job I've ever had in my life, to be honest, to be perfectly honest. Like, every day was just like, I mean, it was a lot on your body. It's on a steel stage, but the girls, the people, the audience, it was really like living a dream, you know?
A lot of people don't realize the hard hours that go into that, not only on stage and the practicing, because I can remember you talking about that, but even, you know, the public relations appearances and the media appearances that you guys had to do.
Oh, yeah. I mean, we were definitely a spokesperson for Radio City Music Hall. We were all media trained. Some of us they liked more than others. I was a favorite.
You have to tell us the secret.
Okay.
How did they get those kicks all the same line? I mean, everybody's kicks, I mean, just measure up unbelievably.
Boom, boom, boom. To the eye high each time.
That's right, to the eye high each time.
Well, it's an illusion that they create on stage that we're all the same height. So basically, they put the tallest girls in the center and then they gradually descend so the shortest girls are on the end. And then when you all kick eye high, it looks as if we're all kicking the same no matter what our body type.
So what are some of the other things that you've been able to do?
So then I came back from that. A real highlight was getting to be on the cover of Vanity Fair with James Gandolfini.
And of course, we know the late James Gandolfini from The Sopranos, a fabulous character actor.
Amazing actor. Annie Leibovitz shot. And so it was a really cool thing to get to.
And not only were you on the cover, you were actually on his lap. I mean, kind of stretched across his body there.
Yeah. My dad just kind of put that picture under everything else. It's like,
So movies, you've done all kinds of things on TV, movies, magazine covers. Well, now you have your own fashion line. Of course, Kandice Pelletier swimwear. So let's talk about that and what led you in, because you're really passionate about this.
Yeah, you know, I said the Rockettes was the hardest job. This may have turned into the hardest job. It's my little baby. My mom, actually, when I was competing in pageants and growing up, she used to make my swimsuits, make my competition outfits. She made my audition leotards when I auditioned for Rockettes. And as I was gearing out of entertainment, I looked at her and she was doing custom for all these pageant girls across the country. And I was like, Mom, what are we going to do with this business?
what are we going to do?
Because she had so much talent and I was sort of that picky daughter who wanted everything to be perfect. You probably remember from our pageant days when you were helping me. So I think that that was sort of the beginning of it. Miss New York asked us to do all the swimwear for their show. So I was like, great, this is a first start. So that was the start into doing small quantity production. And then this year, we had the opportunity to dress all the Miss USA contestants.
Wow.
So, yeah.
Well, Kandice, it's been wonderful catching up with you. I could sit here and talk for you for days, and I hope you'll come back and visit us here on the Southern Scene.
I'd love to, and I love the show, Nat.
It's always great to see you. If you'd like more information on Kandice Pelletier, you'd like to find out more about her fashion line, Kandice Pelletier Swimwear, all you have to do is go to the information you see right there on your screen. Believe me, you want to take a look at these swimsuits.